Hey Arjun, what's that?
This giant speaker system.
Can you lift it?
I don't know. It's hard to grip.
And so what you're seeing here is a music system which I got from Amazon for about $120. And here is the packaging. This is a huge box, right? If you want to compare it with the door there, right? So that gives you an idea. This is pretty, it's almost 6 feet long package. So this is a 700 watt music system from LG. It has two left and right speakers, and then there is a big ass subwoofer here. Total wattage is 700 RMS, and it has a CD tray if you are old school and you want to play CD, which I don't intend to, but you know, it's there. And it has a couple of USB ports, so you can stick in your USB drive and play music from that. It has one cool feature called recording to USB, which I have not tried, but it is really intriguing. And it's basically you stick in the USB drive, and then whatever music you are playing, you can record it to the USB. And this kind of reminds me of, you know, when I was a kid and we would record music from radio to audio cassettes. I've not done that for like decades now. But that is something which, you know, the younger audience, you guys may not even be, you may have never experienced this. But we used to make mixtape and we would record stuff from whatever source we could find, like radio, for example. So I think here what you can do is you can take your music from Spotify or from your Google Music, and you can stream it to this player via Bluetooth, and while your music is playing, you can also record it to a USB stick, which is kind of cool. And I think if you're using it for your personal use, it's perfectly legal. So that is something which I didn't even know existed until I got this system and I saw. So let me give you a brief demo of, let me just show you the different options. So this guy comes with a remote, and the way it is designed, they expect you to use remote for all the features. So right now I have set it to auxiliary mode here, and the auxiliary input is behind. So if I can show you, okay, so you see those red and these, the red and white, that's the aux input. And this actually I have connected this to my Chromecast. You see that Chromecast there? That's my Chromecast audio. And so I can stream music from all, you know, Spotify, Google Music, Pandora, whatever service you use. And I can directly play it to this, which is really convenient. So that is one option. And the other option is the Bluetooth option. So this supports Bluetooth. And the Bluetooth reception is really, really strong. I mean, I've been able to stream Bluetooth from my phone from the other room. This is sitting in my bedroom, by the way. But I have been able to stream from my living room, and it is able to receive it without any issues. So if you go to the remote, here there is the function button, and it's expected, you know, you're supposed to just toggle through various options. So this is auxiliary, portable, I don't know what that is. This is Bluetooth, so that's what I use. So you set this to Bluetooth, and then you can pair your smartphone. Okay, so let's do a quick demo of Bluetooth. So the receiver is set to Bluetooth. It says Bluetooth ready. And all you have to do is, here is my phone. I go to my Bluetooth option. Let me go there. And so in Bluetooth, it shows that first entry LG CM4550. That's our receiver, the same model, right? CM4550. So that's how it will show up in your phone. And you just connect. Okay, so it's connected. So let's do a demo. Let's go here. And see, it says Galaxy S. So it understands the, you know, the source. So this is my Galaxy S8 phone, and it is now paired. So I will play some copyright free music, because YouTube will flag this video otherwise. So let's play this guy. This is from YouTube. Okay. So this is playing via Bluetooth. Here's the volume. Like, I want to be an astronaut. You tie your eyes and wait for no one. We find ourselves asking, what do it's really loud. I mean, this is just at 15. It goes all the way to 40. So you can get, let me, okay. So this volume right now, it is a 7. It goes all the way to 40. And I think my windows will explode if I go that high. So I will just keep it here. So through Bluetooth, if you had, this was one of the concerns I had. I thought, like, if, you know, if I'm using Bluetooth, maybe it may not be that loud, but this guy is really loud. So that's definitely a plus. Now you have these pre-selected modes in the remote. So for example, you see these sound effect here. So this will just toggle through various sound options. So right now it is standard. You can go to natural. Let me increase the volume to, so that you can appreciate the, you know, the various settings. Let's go to 10. Okay. So let's see. Natural. Yeah, I don't know what that is. And there is something, I won't even bother pronouncing it. Samba. Salsa. That's pop. It's classic. Jazz. Rock. Bass. I guess if you're watching football. Flat response. Boost. Okay, so let's get back to standard. Okay, so those are the various sound options. I prefer it just on, you know, standard. It sounds pretty good. So that is one mode, which is Bluetooth. Let's go over some other options. Okay, so let's go back to our phone and stop it. I will disconnect my Bluetooth. Okay, so let's disconnect. Okay, so this is gone. Now I have let's try, I have Pandora running here, and I will go back and pick some music. Let's say solo piano radio. Let's do some classic music, right? So this right now I have connected to LG, so I'm using Chromecast. So if you want to so I already have Chromecast audio, and I've hooked that to my auxiliary, right? So I will go function, and let's go to aux. So this is now Chromecast audio. This is a nice piano, solo piano music. Okay, so that's another option. Let's do some more. Unfortunately, I won't be able to try out the CD because I don't have any CD. So I'm sorry about that, but there is a CD tray here. Okay, I think you can even eject from the remote. Let's see. Is there an eject button? Yeah, there is. So here is the eject button. This one. So let me press that. And there you go. That's your CD tray. Right, so you can play CD old school. And you have Bluetooth, you have aux, auxiliary input, and I'm using Chromecast audio. And what else? Yes, there is radio. So let's try FM radio. So let's go to USB 1, USB 2, aux, portable, Bluetooth, LG TV. This is, if you have a LG TV, it will pair with your TV. I think it uses Bluetooth, and that's a proprietary protocol between LG products, so it will seamlessly connect with your TV and you can use this as your home theater system. I don't have LG TV, so I will never use this function. So this is radio. This is FM radio. And so the way the radio works, let me show you, let me increase the volume. Okay, so the radio is, they have an antenna which I wanted to show you. So if you see here, this thing, this wire is the antenna. So it's just a wire, right? It's a long wire and I have just dropped it. There is no physical antenna, it's just a wire. But you take the wire and you just, you know, let it hang, and it is able to catch the all your FM stations. So, well, while we are here, let me show you the connectivity. So this is the back of the main unit, and this has your connection for the left and the right speakers, and then this orange connection is for the subwoofer. This is the auxiliary connection, which is currently hooked up to Chromecast audio. This is FM radio, and these are your two left and right boxes. This unit looks really, really gorgeous. It's this red and black. It looks really cool. And so this is this huge volume control. And this lights up red when you turn it on, which makes it look so cool. This is the subwoofer unit. It's a pretty big subwoofer. So this whole thing cost me just $120. And it's still available on Amazon. And I highly recommend it. Actually, I was not even interested in getting a full-fledged, you know, music system. I was interested in kind of getting speakers. This is my bedroom, so I just wanted some speaker for my bedroom. And when I started looking, I saw these bookshelf speaker sets, and they are not amplified. So then you need to buy a stereo receiver. And when I started adding up all the cost, it was costing me more than what I paid for this, right? So it made no sense to go and spend money on just a pair of bookshelf speaker and then, you know, some kind of an amplifier. And I'm really surprised that these things, I remember like 10 years back, these kinds of music system, they used to cost $500-$600. Now the price has come down significantly. The old school ones had like, you know, 5-6 CD changer. I guess that's why, you know, that was like a very elaborate mechanical, you know, setup to have 6 CD changer. Now this doesn't have any of that. Nobody uses CD anyway. So they have been able to cut price by getting rid of all that. So the primary usage for me is going to be the auxiliary input via my Chromecast audio and Bluetooth. And if that's what you plan to do, I will give this a thumbs up. It's really loud. The bass from the subwoofer is awesome. No distortion, plays really nice from both Bluetooth and from auxiliary. FM radio also sounds good. So definitely check it out on Amazon. Let me give you the product name. This is called LG Mini Hi-Fi System CM4550. And I saw Best Buy was also selling this, although I'm not sure if they were selling it for $120. Maybe they were a little higher. So definitely, guys, check it out. Okay, bye.